Hey guys, so another Get Ready With Me video, and this time I'm going to focus on a base that is great for oily skin and for sun protection. So even though you're going outside and you're oily, you can't skip your sun protection because it makes you even more oily or greasy. You gotta have the SPF. And so from the products that I own, this is the best face that I have made so far that stays non-oily, so non-shiny and non-greasy, but offers me a ton of SPF and is great. So here we go. So the first thing I'm going to apply is a base, and this is the NARS makeup primer with SPF, PA++, SPF 20 sunscreen, and I don't think they make this anymore. They've kind of done an improved version, so that one I think is PA++. I'm going to take that much and just apply it all over. The next step is to take my Laura Mercier mineral powder with SPF 15 and my Real Techniques buffing brush, and I use the shade Tender Rose, and I'm gonna buff that all over my skin. All done with that. The next step is to conceal. And I will be using my Makeup Forever Full Cover Concealer because I really like this for underneath my eyes. And it's waterproof. And now I'll be taking my Bobbi Brown Creamy Concealer in Porcelain with my Real Techniques Deluxe Crease Brush. And in the comments on a previous Get Ready With Me video, someone was saying that I should perhaps use the Makeup Forever on my chin and the Bobbi Brown on my eyes, but I find that it works better this way in terms of matching my skin tone. For some reason, the Makeup Forever Full Cover looks very strange on my chin. It pulls like really orangish and doesn't look like a good match at all. So I really only like using it underneath my eyes. I was pretty disappointed when I first got it. I didn't think I was gonna be able to use it, but underneath my eyes it works. So then a step that I think has actually been really beneficial in helping me out is I've been using this Smashbox Photo Set Finishing Powder, and this is an SPF 15, over all of my makeup, and I think it's been doing a really good job of keeping my face very, very shine free. I will be using the Real Techniques Contour Brush to apply this. Just put some on and then tap it off, and okay, so all done with that. I really do use quite a bit of this. I just push it all up into my skin, and it doesn't make me look matte or bad or anything. It doesn't look cakey at all. I can kind of see like a very slight dewy glow coming off when I rotate my face, so loving that lately. It's been sitting in my drawer for a while and I've been kind of neglecting it, and now I'm like, oh my god, it's awesome. So instead of using my MAC Studio Fix powder, which I kind of like because it gave a little bit more coverage, I'd prefer to just stick with that as my setting powder from now on. And for my cheeks, I'm going to be using NARS Gaeity. I believe that's how it's pronounced. Gaeity. It's very bright because I'm going to be doing a pink lip. In case I didn't say, I'm going to do this NYX matte lipstick in shocking pink. So I kind of went for a little matchy-matchy look with my cheeks and my lips. So this is NARS Gaeity. I just gave myself a slight pink flush. Nothing too dramatic because I don't want to be crazy blush, crazy lips, crazy anything. And the next step, I'm gonna take a little bit of this Benefit Stay Don't Stray. This is their eye stay put primer for concealers and eyeshadows. Oh, one time I used this underneath my eye. Don't do that, it looked awful. Just experimenting. This doesn't have as much coverage as Painterly Paint Pot does for covering up veins on my eyelids, but it's a very good primer nonetheless. I don't have any creasing issues when I use this. I'm also gonna apply a little bit of NARS Copacabana Illuminator on the tops of my cheekbones. And I know I've already powdered my face and everything, but whatever. Oops, I squirted out like way too much. I'm holding this brush in my hand because I plan to use the brush, but look at me go with my fingers. Most of the highlighters that I have are more like kind of goldy, so this is a nice pearly glow. I'm also going to apply a little bit of that to my eyelids. And I'm going to fill in my brows with my MAC eyebrow pencil in Spiked. So now that I have my brows painted on, I'm going to set them with some of this Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Gel. This is just a sample I received from Sephora. But it's going strong. I've been using it for like 6 months. This stuff works pretty well. It's very much like hairspray for your brows. They won't be going anywhere. They do feel a little crispy, but I don't really spend much of my day, you know, feeling up my brows, so I think it's okay. I don't mind it as long as they stay in place and that they look nice. It can do whatever it wants. And now I'm going to take from my Smashbox Studio Stash Shadow Palette. I received this in kind of like a little Smashbox kit a while ago, and I love Smashbox. I feel like not enough people seem to be talking about them on YouTube. Not that they have to be, but just I think maybe they're an underrated brand. I think they're quite nice and I like their stuff. On my Ego Tools highlight brush, just because it's what I have that's clean, I'm going to take, oh, they don't have names. Well, this kind of silvery shadow and apply that just kind of like in my crease. And then I'm gonna take the cream color and just use my finger to kind of blend that up. And I also thought it would maybe be kind of fun or just absolutely painful and torturous, worse than hearing me try to pronounce scop. That's how it is. I'm only gonna say it once. I'm going to try to apply some gel eyeliner, and this is MAC's Blacktrack Fluid Line. I know everyone says that this stuff is the worst because it dried out, but look at mine, and look how like moist and nice it looks. Now here's the freaky fact. I've owned this for like 4 years. Number one, that's probably kind of gross in terms of like bacteria, but I so rarely wear gel eyeliner that I think it just was closed nice and securely, and it's always just stayed really moist. So I'm not gonna throw it away just yet. I'm the only person who's ever used it, so, you know, whatever. If that's like really unsanitary though, let me know. I don't really want to buy a new one. So I'm going to take the Don Mari palette and try this out. No, my hooded, look what it did. Hate hooded lids. Okay, that's probably the most even I've ever made eyeliner look in my life, which is not really saying much, but there it is, guys. What generally happens is I tend to make a thin line and I end up making it too thick. So I go, oh shit, gotta go make it thick on the other side. And then you just end up with what you get. And I have hooded eyes, so that's why I never really like eyeliner on me. So you, if you have this, you really have to open your eyes and draw what you want it to look like while your eyes are open and like make the shape that you want it to look like, because it might look weird when you close your eyes because it's like up on a different part of your skin. It's like on the hood part, but if you want it to look good when your eyes are open, which is most of the time, you kind of have to look straight on and apply it like that. You have to do the same thing with crease stuff too, because I just have, it's not like baggy eyelids, but just they're kind of hooded. The last step for my eyes is I'm going to apply some mascara, and this is the Smashbox Bionic Lash, and I got this in another one of the kits, probably the same kit I got some of the other stuff in, and I really like it. I was very, very surprised by it, so you'll see. The brush feels really nice too. So this is the Smashbox Bionic Mascara. It's quite nice and it feels really great to apply. Like, I don't know, it just feels like everything about it is so smooth, like taking it out feels just so smooth, and when you're applying it, it just feels like you're applying, like the equivalent of like applying just like a really amazing like creamy lipstick. That's kind of what it feels like for your eyelashes. Oh, damn it, I was gonna start curling my eyelashes and I brought this down and I didn't. Rats. I'm gonna take a little bit of this brown eyeliner in Lionfish, just because I realized I have it down here, and kind of apply a little bit to the top waterline. Just to kind of complete the blackness of the look. So that was the Stila Smudge Stick in Lionfish, and then I'm gonna take a little bit of the same thing, a Stila Smudge Stick, but this is in Silver Dollar, and I'm gonna line my bottom in silver. So now the last step is to take NYX Matte Lipstick in Shocking Pink and apply it to my lips. And to try to help hold it all in place, I'm going to use the Urban Decay D-Slick Oil Control Makeup Setting Spray and put a couple pumps of that on my face. Okay guys, so that is the finished look. I've got shocking pink on my lips. It is a gorgeous, awesome, bright, shocking pink color. I've got gel eyeliner on, something I don't normally always do, but I love gel eyeliner with a pink lip. I think it looks really good. And hopefully this makeup would last me in the sun, in the shade, in whatever, if I get sweaty. I've got some waterproof concealer. I've got SPF and it's all powder, and the setting powder is really good. I've got the oil control setting spray. So thank you guys so much for watching and have a good day.